the confidence he has shown during the campaign period, President Duterte now doubts whether he will be able to stop corruption in government as he had earlier promised.
I have a duty that is a burden, sometimes more than I can carry. I can almost cry. Sabi ko na hindi ko kaya itong corruption. At lo, sabi ko nung nagsisi ako, kasi akala ko within the constitutional powers na binigay sa akin, kaya ko. Pero sa batas na ito, constitution, even if you give me 20 years, I cannot do it. Maghanap uli kayo ng Marcos.
The president's statement comes after the president improved its ranking in the Corruption Perception Index of Transparency International. The country jumped 12 places in 2018 to rank 99th out of 180 countries. The palace says President Duterte has not wavered in his resolve to remove government officials tainted with corruption, even in his third year in office. However, even the agency created by Duterte to stamp out corruption in government is doubting whether the president will be able to fulfill his own campaign promise. Aside from the high-profile firings, the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission has looked into numerous cases of corruption and has so far endorsed 29 of them to the Office of the Ombudsman. But Advocate Dante Jimenez says corruption in Philippine government is rooted to the core.
Because the system rots. Our system is so corrupt. Yan ang nakikita ko message niya eh. Hindi makakaya to under the present situation, under the present constitution. Ako na mismo magsasabi, mahihirapan talaga kahit sinong presidente. Siyempre si presidente hanggang 2022 lang. After him, what? Sino?
The palace explains that even if the president is committed to rid the bureaucracy of corrupt people, his powers are limited when it comes to removing those in the lower ranks.
He cannot remove employees, government corrupt employees, or government employees who are corrupt, because you need to file cases against them. And that will take time. Siguro, tapos na yung term niya, hindi niya pa matatanggal. And we all know that marami sa baba ang engaged in corruption. Yun ang naging problema niya.
Political analyst Edmond Tayo says the chief executive's anti-corruption strategy should not only end in firing the corrupt, as there is a need to understand the workings within each government agency.
Kahit naman sabihin natin na talagang talamak ang korupsyon sa ahensyang ito, pagpalagay mo, eh kung hindi mo naiintindihan yung kabuang takbo ng trabaho ng ahensya, mahihirapan mo ding kumbaga ma-identify saan ba dito yung pwede nating mabago nang sa ganun eh mabawasan yung opportunity for corruption. Systemic kasi.
Despite this, Tayo says there were several changes instituted by the Duterte administration that have been successful in deterring corruption. For example, Duterte's order for agencies to speed up government services.
Kasi alam mo, habang tumatagal ang serbisyo, lalong nagkakaroon ng pagkakataon for corruption. Yan nga yung binabanggit ko kanina. Kapag ka andyan na, free for the taking, eh talagang may incentive. Bakit hindi mo pa kukunin? Eh andyan na. No? So pag tinanggal mo yung ganong opportunity, eh mababawasan.
Even the palace now says eradicating corruption is not a simple matter. But now that the administration has reached its halfway mark, the question remains, is the president's undaunted resolve to stop corruption enough to actually solve the problem? Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.